Voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra.
Ote conspectu hominum quale dilexit.
Why are you praying here?
We pray for strength to face the one within that cave. A devil in man's form, who commands the beasts themselves. Many times we have seen him feeding the wild beasts and speaking with them. Even the wolves do not savage him.
Are you sure? You Christians are quick to name devil that which you do not understand.
The birds in this wood are restless and swift to attack. Only yesterday, a fox snatched a babe from its crib. Have no doubt, he who walks backwards is among us. Either he will come out of there, or we will go in.
Venite, adoremus et adetalas ameros.
Have a care, stranger. Do not speak to him. You're
This is the lair of a man or a beast. You keep company with a bear. Are you as the monk says?
The animals be my friends. I hear them, and they hear me. They hurt this one, now they want to hurt me.
But you have set your beasts on people before.
Them's that hurt my friends get hurt. But I never hurt no baby.
You have only been defending those you love. Stay here, tend to your friend. I will see to the monks outside.
Don't kill them. Don't want that. Scare them off. It's the animals they fear, remember?
Have you slain him? Or has the devil's tongue swayed you?
Terra superbus est lo. Venite audite verbum domini in nostri Jesu Nazareno eras. Ut non videtur eis nimis et aliud considerare.
Ibi in campo intercept septimo diluculo electae.
Time to die!
Hold there, stranger.
The brush won't hide you.
Mm.
I do not know if you are what they say you are, but I've seen to your tormentors. I laid about them with my blade.
Blood brings blood. More will come. Things worse now. Eowyn and I better go somewhere else.
I did what I could. Farewell then, and good fortune. Hunting is a fine sport, but I hope the Ealdorman has not become the prey. No good comes from a camp this bloody. They were caught off guard as they supped. They were attacked by a beast. Something strong enough to kill a horse. Some large prey left these tracks in the grass. The remains of the hunting party. This one was savaged by a large animal. The hunters were prey to a large beast or two. I can only hope that Birstan still lives. Be my eyes, Sunan.
Accept your fate as a beast for bears. Do not let them charge you. I would not have survived this ambush without you.
You have my gratitude to stumble upon me in my moment of greatest peril. Perhaps you were God sent.
I am Estrid sent. Your wife and the Thanes of Essex both want your balls on a blacksmith's anvil.
When do they not?
You could return and report that the savage claw took me. Poor Birstan, his exit pursued by a bear.
And make the beast Lord of Essex in your stead.
No doubt my Estrid would prefer his velvet paws to my calloused hands. So, who are you? A sellsword?
I am Eivor of the Raven Clan. You hinted at an alliance for the loan of my unique talents.
S'blood, yes. Let us return to Colchester at once, and we'll speak more of the delicate matter on my mind. I'm glad you answered my summons. I did not expect such a skilled fighter.
It's good I came when I did. You lost many men on this hunt.
Good men, all. They will have the proper rights, and their families will be cared for.
Your people sacrificed much for your sport.
They did. There is no balm for my tortured heart.
Why did you ask me here?
Do you believe in true love, Eivor?
I have loved.
But have you truly? Has a longing burned in your breast, a sweet, lingering pain, paralyzing you with its sting?
There is pain enough in battle. I do not seek it out in love.
I long for it. The thrill of a fight softly won. My wife Estrid lacks fire. She is a fish out of water, cold and dead.
She showed great passion when I met her. keeping your thanes in check.
Oh, they love her, it is true. Some with too much devotion. Oh, they love her, it is true. Some with too much devotion. And I have not been a good and attentive husband. I have always been a plucked goose in matters of love, and a piss-poor ruler to boot.
Strong must be the hand that steers the ship, Birstan.
My hand would rather tug the catgut of a well-crafted bow, my eyes narrowing at the sight of prey.
Aye, a crown sits heavy on the head.
Then let us run wild and free in the woods as the wolves do. Live on our wits, prowl and stalk and feast.
You have a romantic way about you, Birstan.
Do not fret. My guards will not worry you when we are together.
You mismark me if you think I'm capable of worry. Have you built your city in the ruins of another?
No, these builders are lost to the annals of time. Far advanced of the Saxon hovels of Wattle and Daub. I have ambition to build a great palace myself, with mosaics and balmy courtyards.
What stops you?
That which stops all but the most creative minds. Coin, imagination, talent.
And your people. Is Essex happy?
That is a question I never really ponder. I suppose they are. I hope they are. Alfred believes I rule like a chickless hen, flapping and squawking over nothing but the farmer's dinner.
He interferes.
No, he disapproves. Is that not infinitely worse?
But look!
We are nearing my hall. I must face the wolves at my... Ready to help me fend off the spears of their displeasure?
Let them speak their woes. I'll advise you if I can.
Who is this owl, Birstan, that twitters in your ear?
An advisor, nothing more. Here to help Essex navigate her brewing storms. Now, my dear brethren, Adred, perhaps you will start us off. What troubles you?
You're a disgrace, Birstan. Couldn't get a sow pissed in an alehouse. Alfred's men are crawling all over Essex.
King Alfred, yes. Though it is within his right, the constant presence of his men is certainly an issue.
Are they men or babes? If Alfred meddles in the affairs of Essex, send his men home in shrouds.
Ah, we should challenge his right to rule. Was not Essex once a thriving kingdom of its own? We should fight, yes, fight! And you, Wyatt, what do you say?
Your preparations for the Lammas Festival. How can you think of spending so much coin when your people are starving?
Often should one make an early meal, nor fasting come to the feast.
The feast, yes. The festival! This is not for full bellies, but to bless the loaf. Does that not bring us all good fortune? And Aldrich, do you yap like a she-hound as Adred does?
You know my thoughts, Birstan. The feared. How can we give men to Alfred for his wars when our harvest suffers day by day?
Do they not defend your land? You'll need all the men you can muster to fight the coming wars.
The Danes are a great threat when provoked. Those we cannot ally with, we must fight or lose our lands. There. Have I not answered all your questions?
You are a stain on this shire, Birstan. Useless.
Useless?
That's right. Yet still you haunt my hall. Be gone. I haven't time for your squabbling. That ceased their prattling. A fine outcome, Eivor. The very soul of balance.
A firm hand is all you need, Birstan. Whether on your hunting bow or on your helm.
All this talk of hunting makes me long for the woods.
Your wife awaits, Birstan. Are you not worried some other man will drench your sheets with his sweat?
Ha! She does as she must. As do I. But you will discover this soon enough.
done the impossible, Dane. Returned my errant gander to his coop.
My pettish love. Such a stormy countenance clouds the sun of my return.
Your thanes drank the ale the abbot gifted us. All of it.
Now that is a tragedy my heart will not easily overcome.
If he looked at me with the same affection he shows for hunting deer, our marriage might have survived.
I noticed your love has gone sour. Was it fresher than this?
There is so little difference between love and hate. It's difficult to say where the sourness comes from.
So, what do you need of me?
Our affairs are more of heart than of state, Eivor. What little passion there was between us faded into bickering long ago.
We would have our freedom, Eivor. I from my wife, and my wife from Essex.
I am too sharp a weapon for so soft a task. Why not part and be done with it?
Oh, were I a Dane, and divorce as simple as a slit throat. But it's not so easy as that.
Does your god not allow husbands and wives to part?
Our god? Our king? There is much standing in the way of a joyous uncoupling. Ours was an arranged marriage, a political need, and not easily broken.
Explain yourselves clear and plain, and I will do it. The poetry here is mind mud.
We had a plan, a simple plan. A woman lost and a woman found.
Some time ago, we paid a Dane to kidnap me and ferry me safely to Francia. As you can see, he did not deliver.
He was certainly thorough in other regards.
Some Norse can be quick to take coin and slow to earn it. If I give my word, it is not broken.
Could we try the kidnap again? Much of the planning is done. It would only take a more trustworthy overseer.
It should be a bold venture if we do. Loud and brash and seen by all.
During our Lammas festival, merry peasants and guards with wandering eyes.
Your return to Francia would need a swift ship, with a captain ready to leave England.
We could ask him.
I would have thought his steed and seamen spent.
Come find me in the market, Eivor. Our unwelcome guests require food and ale to soften their anger.
My wife is a gracious and attentive host, Eivor. The only thing that keeps my braying thanes at bay.
And the woman found?
A darling maybud, Alfida, my childhood sweetheart. I left her 20 years ago in Molden to marry my prickled pear.
20 years? Can an ember so cold be reignited?
We can hope. You must fan the flame. Find her, bring her to my lakeside cottage, and light a bonfire there. I will know to come. I believe she lived in the last house in Molden. A small, sweet place where fond memories were made.
I will do as you both ask, and ask Freya for success in this love game.
Good luck in your endeavors, Eivor. I pray you find my Alfida with a fair face and a yearning heart.
Now, should I look for Alfida first, or meet with Estrid at the marketplace?
She will remember me, won't she? Yet what if she's... Buried in a cold clay earth.
It's Chef Leonard, love!
Chef! Leonard!
Help! What? Throw the water!
Go in now. Agnek. Got him. Get off. Now, over.
Here!
drunkest fool.
Get the murdering heathen!
Alfida remember a lover from so long ago. Would I? Survey the area, Sunan.
What's where, Dola?
The last house in Malden. Alvida should be here. He will attack on sight here. Someone was interrupted preparing their supper. Taken or fled. Second bed. Alvida doesn't live alone.
Leave me be, warmonger! You have my sister! Is that not enough?
Peace, boy. I'm not with these men. I came to speak with your sister, that's all.
A Dane in Essex. Now here's a day riddled with strange portents and happenings.
What is your name?
I'm Ellerich, the man of this house. Who are you? And why have you come?
I'm looking for your sister, at the behest of another.
Behest? We've got no money to speak of, and my sister is well past the marrying age.
Do you know where they're holding Alvida?
Yet another stay at the King's pleasure. The prison camp at Brentwood. Far to the west.
I'll bring her to the lake house north of there. Meet us there if you wish.
If you promise you will find her, I will.
Where's the cord?
now know. Nesta Ferra.
So Aiken Lam, say me.
Sound almost human, but gods,
your skin was pale as midnight mist, hair threaded with dew. Please, my love, you must forgive me. I cannot sleep, I cannot eat.
Who do you speak to? There's no one here.
We are together now, wife. You will never leave my side, whispering in my ear like a moth's wings.
Where is that wailing coming from? It is as if the walls are crying out in anguish. This man is haunted by some terrible deed.
Your skin was pale as midnight mist, hair threaded with dew. So classy, accusing.
You! You blew upon the threads and they severed! She is gone! Dust and bones! Dust and bones!
You have done some mischief here. I can smell the guilt in flesh.
No! No! What have you done?
He murdered his love. Little wonder he's crazed with guilt. Must be black from the other side. Sunan, guide me.
Heathen!
Have my sincere thanks, friend. Why were you tied up?
A wee misunderstanding between myself and the good folk of the hamlets hereabouts. Your name, good kin?
I am Eivor of the Raven Clan, and now I have freed you, so go about your business.
Wait! May I inquire? The dulcet timbre of your voice, the godlike strength of your gait. You are a warrior, yes? A lone skiff bobbing on the sea of opportunity. Wait, What is that on the horizon? Adventure! The stars prophesized our meeting. I am the Glee Woman, Aswig the Mellifluous. You have heard of me? No matter. Destiny has made you my muse. I shall follow you, record your great deeds with poetry. When danger rears its ugly head, Eivor balks and just stops dead. Fleet of foot and long of gait, oh Eivor, do I prate your fate? Eivor climbing like a spider. Oh, I'm honored to be beside her. This will not make great poetry, Eivor! Do something! Anything! Eivor running from the past with mighty speed to flabbergast!
Enough. Stop following me.
I cannot, for walking in your footsteps has let me sup at the cup of inspiration. You are my life's great purpose.
Enough! I won't listen to your blabber anymore.
First there was a famine, and now, look here, a feast! Fare thee well, Eivor of the Raven Clan. Your exploits will live on in me.
Now, I thank you, but please, take your leave.
Fare thee well, brave hero! Perhaps we will meet again!
Gods, I hope not.
Now you pay!
Best not to draw attention here.
Hmm.
strike! Don't let us lose!
Birstan's love, Alfida. They haven't broken her spirit.
Someone! What? What is this? You're not one of them!
Stay quiet. I'm here to free you.
I cannot walk. My ankle. They were not gentle with me.
Then I will carry you.
Who are you? Who risked so much to save me?
A friend.
Of Elarch's? Is he all right? The poor boy?
Not your brother. Someone else who wishes to rekindle a friendship.
I will need to find a key.
Gentler, please.
You'll soon be safe. Rest easy.
They beat me.
Almost there.
Bless the saints!
Rest now. Soon you'll be up and about again.
Alfida! Did they hurt you?
Takes more than some cockshy milksops to break my will. Beating a boy half to death for stealing bread? I'll not see it done.
Growling bellies mean nothing to those pay swords.
Elarich, pay more mind to the world. It is cruel and dark for those who cannot stand up for themselves.
Alfida, could we speak in private?
He is a good boy. But without a father to guide him, he's grown softer than I'd hoped.
You raised him alone. Where were your parents when he was a child?
Dead of the plague that came when he was 3 months born. So to shun your door when you have a babe on your teat. Now it's your turn. Why did you come for me?
I am here, at the request of Ealdorman Birstan. He wonders if you could love him again.
Love him? Dear old Birstan, he remembers.
He does.
I've thought of him sometimes myself. But with my brother to fend for, I could not waste a life mooning.
He has thought of nothing but you, Alfida. And with his wife Estrid returning to Francia, he sent me to find you.
How it would work between me and him? I'm a poor woman. Have been always. But the Ealdorman... Oh, God, help me! I'll give him a go. How could I not? Oh, bless.
He will come if you call. At the lighting of the bonfire, he will ride here to meet you.
Elarich, come you and sit with us. I have something to say.
My apple blossom girl. Is it really you?
It is. Though crows have left their footfalls around my eyes.
They still shine brightly, as when we were children. Has Eivor told you all?
Aye, she has.
And do you accept me, love? My heart feels like it will burst.
Give her time, Birstan. A passion rekindled in haste will soon fall to embers.
Of course. You are absolutely right. And we have a lifetime to recapture what was mislaid.
I hope it will not take that.
And this young lad is Elevich, Alvida's brother.
Hello, your worshipfulness.
I am Birstan, nothing more or less. And you are a fine, strong lad of... how old?
19 summers.
He's all the family I have, Birstan. If I'm to stay, you must welcome us both into your heart.
We have one half of our bargain done, Birstan. I will return with news of the other.
Does this mean we're leaving Malden?
You are, my boy. To live with me in Colchester. Perhaps I can teach you the joy of the hunt.
Before you go, Elovrich, I would suggest a long, slow walk around the lake. To plan the kidnap. Istrid waits for me.
Dear Birstan, I cannot believe you would come for me after all these years.
I never stopped thinking of you, Alvida.